Dramatic showdown on Capitol Hill over gun control. Former Arizona Congresswoman Gabby Giffords and her husband, Mark Kelly, facing off against the leader of the NRA.
Law-abiding gun owners will not accept blame for the acts of violent or deranged criminals, nor do we believe that government should dictate what we can lawfully own and use to protect our families.
Speaking is difficult, but I need to say something important. Violence is a big problem. Too many children are dying. Too many children. We must do something.
Mark Kelly says he and his wife are gun owners who have no plans to give up their weapons, and even though they did think about joining the NRA. So can there be a compromise? Joining us right now is Fox News senior judicial analyst Judge Andrew Napolitano. Judge, that's the question. Can you adjust the laws as they are without changing the Constitution?
You know, the people who support the Second Amendment, of which I am one, believe that an adjustment here, a tweaking there, mm-hmm. will open up the doorway to more adjustments in the future, and ultimately the government will be able to choose who carries guns. And one of the things that has kept the country free is fear in the back of the mind of someone who might try to become a tyrant, that way out there are a lot of people who have the firepower to prevent tyranny here. Sure. Mm-hmm. So that's one argument. The other argument underlying the Second Amendment is that the decision to use a weapon to protect your life, your liberty, your children, your property is an individual decision and not a government decision, because it's an aspect of self-defense, and that's an individual decision. And the government can't interfere with that decision, nor can it stop you from using the most technologically advanced way to protect your life, liberty, children, and property. So I don't think there's going to be a compromise. I think the president's proposals, which are based on these emotional arguments that tug at everybody's heartstrings. I've chatted with Congresswoman Giffords, as I was telling you. It's a very moving and unforgettable experience. The president's arguments, I think, will fail because he effectively wants to punish the law-abiding because of the horrific behavior of those who break the law.
So do you think that the conversation needs to be away from the Second Amendment and looking more at some of the other factors that may have contributed to some of these massacres that we've seen?
Yes, I do, Gretchen, but the president and his people don't, because they have an ideology called progressivism, started with Woodrow Wilson and Theodore Roosevelt 100 years ago, and almost all presidents, Reagan was an exception, Calvin Coolidge was an exception, think that they can tell us how to live. Yeah. And they will use this as an excuse to tell us how to live by taking guns away from us.
All right.
If they can get away with it.
Indeed. All right, Judge, thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Great analysis.